Es difícil dejar tu isla. Es difícil dejar tus raíces.
Tu costumbre.
Tus costumbres. En un sitio donde tú conoces, no conoces a nadie.
It is far from the place they left a month ago in both distance and culture. But for husband and wife Angie Melendez and Fernando Moyet, this small hotel room in Brooklyn is their family's best shot at a future after their home near Puerto Rico's capital was destroyed by Hurricane Maria. After the hurricane hit, they were forced to sleep for almost a month in their garage. They were given a flight to the mainland by a local charity. They had just one day's notice and three suitcases to pack.
Tres maletas con sueño. Tres maletas de desesperación. Tres maletas de ayuda, de ayúdame, de socorro.
Across New York and around the U.S., many Puerto Ricans are finding themselves adrift because of the September 20th hurricane. Maria destroyed more than 70,000 homes and damaged another 300,000. Many areas are still without power, and many businesses have closed. The result has been a mass exodus to the mainland. According to FEMA, there are nearly 4,000 families receiving hotel assistance from the agency across 42 states because their homes are too damaged to occupy.
I'm like, I adopted 63 families.
Many families are relying on volunteers like Sonia Velasquez to navigate the complicated network of benefits. FEMA has set a March 20th deadline for the program to end, and many families say they can't afford temporary housing without assistance. Velasquez says many families don't know where they'll end up next.
It frustrates me that they are misinformed, right? It frustrates me that there is not a plan, a long-term plan for them.
Eso fue una experiencia horrible.
Across town in Queens, Miguel Rosado has a binder full of pictures documenting the devastation in his hometown of San Juan. He's searching for a permanent home on the mainland for himself, his 10-year-old daughter, and 19-year-old adopted son.
Es estrés, muy estresante, sinceramente. Es como que me siento con un estrés brutal porque no es un lugar seguro. Sé que en cualquier momento me va a decir lo mismo, vete.
According to a study by the Center for Puerto Rican Studies at Hunter College, more than 200,000 Puerto Ricans could move to the U.S. mainland over the next 12 months. The greatest number are expected to settle in Florida. Leslie Rivera from the central town of Caguas has been shuffling among hotels in Tampa since December with her three kids.
Porque no tengo ropa. No tengo nada para mis hijos. Y pues se me hace bien difícil, de verdad.
She was approved for subsidized housing and expects to be settled soon, but tasked with finding a job and raising three kids in an unfamiliar place, the challenges won't end there.
Si yo estuviera sola, pues yo lucho. Pero yo tengo estos tres que son el ejemplo mío.
Robert Bumstead, Associated Press.